today I would like maybe just to take a few topics from the book that I've written, and it's about 7 basic ingredients for a successful marriage. So I would like us to encourage those in marriage and to give them basic ingredients on how to make your marriage to blossom. And one of them, number one, is realistic expectations. In family, set expectations that are realistic to both of you. Don't just think of how you are going to become so great, how you are going to make things, and yet, ukiangalia hata mapato yenu is very little, is very minimal. So just sit down together, set up realistic expectations, and follow through. Then, number two is having a good communication. Know your partner, like your partners, the way they communicate, and know the flaws, the cons, and the pros on how they speak. At times they talk like this and they mean this. So you need to understand each other. You should know people, know your person. Don't just live there in ignorance. Number three, there is conflict resolution capacity. Sit down together and know the challenges, that there will be challenges in marriages, there will arise up challenges. Just know how to handle your challenges when they arise up. So set your own model on how to do your conflict, how to deal with them. Don't just expose your conflict out there. Don't just speak to just everybody. Know how to solve them. Number four, liking a person's, liking a partner's personality. We've come from different family background. We come from different cultures in marriage. Even if you come from the same community, the same language, there are different cultures in the home. Set your own culture in your home as a family. Just come up together and say, now this is going to be us, this family, this is our culture, we'll do this, we'll go like that. Don't follow others, don't emulate others, because what works for others may not necessarily work for you. Number five, ethical values and common religion. Many are the times that we want to follow certain things because we found our people doing it. Maybe in the community, you find that there are roles that have been set for men and roles for women, and we just want to stick with that even in our marriages. What we saw our father doing, our mother doing, we want to emulate the same, to bring the same into our marriage. Just know that when you marry people from a different religion, with the intention that you'll change them, you may never change them. So what you need to do, just look for people of your own place, people that you can cope up together, people that you can stay together. Number six is agreement on each partner's responsibilities. Sit down and agree who will do what in the home. It does not mean that because the husband is the head of the family, the husband is there and he cannot provide, and that the wife cannot be given opportunity to work. I always tell couples that empower your wives, let them do things, so that even when it comes to worst moments, when you can't do anything, she will be providing for the family. I know of a friend and a couple who the husband has not been working for the last 2 years, but it's the wife who is paying everything. She's paying the rent, she's doing everything in the house co, she's paying the school fees for the children. One of the child is in the university, the other one is in Form 4, and they are paying a great deal. Why? Because they just sat down and they agreed on each partner's responsibility, pending how you earn, what you get, and at one moment, what moment. And the last thing is agreeing on how to employ free time. So just sit down and say that during our free time, our leisure time, we are going to employ it, we are going to use it in this way and that way. And there is one more ingredient that I would like to add that is in my book. It's about sex and sexuality, a very key component in marriage. Many times Paul said in 1 Corinthians chapter 7 verse 2 that if to avoid fornication, let every man have their own wife, let every wife, every woman have her own husband. So if you have found yourself in marriage, make sure that you utilize that moment good and completely. It does not make up when you go out to look for sex in some other places and yet you are married, you have it in the family. What I'm saying today is that try to look for model. Marriage, sex is one of the ingredients that make up for marriage. So in marriage, look for ways. In marriage, look for your own styles that will make for you. In marriage, make sure that Paul said that your body is no longer yours, but your wife's. And your wife is not her, but yours. I've met friends and people in the Christian era who, when they have been taught by denominational religion, that when they are in fasting, they abstain from sex. But Paul said that when you want to abstain from it, make sure that you agree with your partner, in advance, let them agree together with you. If they don't give you the consent, then don't fast on that area, fast on other things. So that is the book that I've written. I'm Patrick Marindany, as they say, and if you want to find me, if you want to get me, just go to Dr. Duo's place, that is in the National Bank Plaza, and you will find me there. That's where we do our counseling, our professional counseling. Come also to our church, and in the church also we do the counseling, the corporate counseling. Thank you.